Now we will discuss selection of cheese culture, and I think this is one of the most critical element in production of good quality cheese, because it has to be based on a lot of scientific research, as well as a lot of care has to be exercised in making these cheese cultures. So this is the utmost importance, as I said. Normally the manufacturer of starter cultures especially, they are the very much specialized people or group of people or companies that produce starter culture, and they work very closely with the end user, which are cheese manufacturer. This is one of the very important application of biotechnology, in fact, where we produce starter cultures of desirable end products of fermented category. They are very specialized people. It's a very specialized science that needs to do a lot of concentrated work in this area. And there's a lot of development taking place, because this gives an edge to any end product, because the quality of end product is very much dependent upon the type of cultures that are used. And if you have a superior culture, then of course you have an edge over the other manufacturer because of the good quality produced by these starter cultures. As we earlier discussed, the starter culture can come in different shapes. They can be liquid for mother culture propagation. They can be used in the form of deep frozen concentrate. They can be freeze dried, or they can be deep frozen or freeze dried form. So these all forms are basically used. They all have their own benefits when they are used in the industry. But I think one of the most important thing is that this form of making starter culture would preserve these culture for use for a longer time, because in industrial processes we need to have consistent quality of end product for a very long time, for many years, because the product has to be maintain its quality characteristics, and it is only possible if you can maintain and preserve these cultures. Whenever there's any mutation or change in these cultures, that would actually, it can be very devastating for the manufacturers of yeast. So once we have this starter culture available in this farm, it also reduces the need for maintaining all this culture within a factory environment, because there are more chances of contamination there. So that facilitates the process of making a fermented product if we have the starter culture in these farms, which are preserved for a very long time. Normally, the dairy plants would have a starter culture room. They are very much specialized room. We have to take a lot of extra care to avoid any kind of contamination, any opportunity of contamination. We have to control the environment very critically. We have to look at, there are no yeast or mold or bacteriophages. They cannot get entry into these premises through any means, because if they get into the starter culture, that could lead to very devastating results, and the end product would be not of the good quality. Normally, the large plants would have these starter culture in the form of frozen shapes, or they can be freeze-dried, and they are given to these larger plants where they can make them into bulk cultures, because industrial processes are very large processes. Very higher amount of these cultures are used, so they have to be made into bulk before the start of fermentation process. They are cooled and stored, and shelf life would vary, because again, once they are made into bulk, we have to maintain the environmental conditions so that they can be stored for a longer time. Normal life is 9 to 12 months if they are stored at minus 18 degree C or minus 45 degree C. As you can see, there's a very low temperature, because minus 18 or minus 45 temperature has to be maintained for the preservation of these cultures, because otherwise there might be growth of some psychrophiles or some other bacteriophages that can disturb these starter cultures. So if we want to maintain the consistency, as I earlier said, of the final product, and for a very, very, very long time, for example, many years, because the end product that is accepted in the market, it would remain in the market for a very, very long time. So as long as the cheese has to remain in the market, the starter culture must be preserved and maintained for the same amount and length of time. So that is why this is very important that we maintain and keep our starter cultures in a very nice manner. And one of the opportunity for biotechnologists is to work on these areas of making starter cultures for different products, whether they are cheese or whether they are for other fermented products such as meat or vegetables, as this is one of the very technically and scientifically very profound area that needs to be worked properly.